Greetings, Earthlings and survivors and boys and girls, guys and gals, ladies and gentlemen, friends and foes. Welcome back to Paul Plays Minecraft. All right, it's time to get started on today's project. Now, I have not done any farming, as you can see here, but let me just show you one cool thing here with this new sword. By the way, I had some lovely suggestions to name this sword. And, of course, a sword like this, awesome, needs a name. However, I'm going to have to spend some levels on that, so I don't think I can name it just yet. But one of the suggestions, which was pretty cool, was Wilhelm, since it has knockback. And I knocked the creeper into the ravine over there the last time. The Wilhelm scream is the one that you always hear in movies, like, ah, and somebody falls. So we'll be doing that. But Wilhelm is a good name. But the problem with that is it doesn't really have the flavor of the jungle and the ruins and the mine and Incan's ruins. So I think I'm going to hold off and think up something a little more appropriate. But it is a cool name. Anyway, let's kill some chickens because they're awfully noisy. We're going to be working right over there building up a train stop. So let me show you what the sword can do since it has fire and looting, which is pretty sweet. There we go. See that? It cooked a chicken. So not a does it slice? It dices, it slices, it cooks, too. That's pretty cool. How much would you pay for a sword that does this? But don't answer yet, because I will include this free suitcase filled with rocks. I couldn't think of anything better. But yeah, you know those late-night TV programs, right? Ones that try to sell you Ginsu knives. Do they still make Ginsu knives? Oh, boy. All right, my grandmother had thousands of those things. She always fell for that. Anyway, they were good knives, though, I must say. Okay, let's get started here. We're off on a tangent. First, we're going to get rid of that to deactivate that rail. And in fact, we're going to move that rail. First things first, I want to raise this up a little bit with some dirt. And because we're going to build a platform here. This is not going to be a full train station, but it's going to be rather a platform with a little overhang. Just it's going to be a train stop, you know, a stop rather than a full station. I don't think we need a full station right here. It might look a little strange. So we're going to have I'm thinking a raised platform up one block, and I'll show you why we're going to do that here momentarily. But yeah, I think right here ought to be fine. I'm going to stick with the jungle wood theme because I have, well, because that's all I have. Really? So we'll stick with that. Do I have an axe? I do. And we're going to pick this stuff up and salvage some of it. And I'll fill that in with dirt. I'm thinking a small platform, 3x4 something? I don't know. Let's fill this in. Let's try to get a gauge here. All right, now give me that back. Not enough hands. All right, we'll have it. I want this centered, so why don't we put the platform like, let's see if I go 1, 2, 3 here. 1, 2, 3. Whoops. I think that's okay if that stays there. So we're going to have the rail come up this way and then down here. And over here, we're going to have little benches. So it looks like I'm going to need to go there. And there. And there. All right, we'll just make it like this for now. And then we can cut into this later. The idea in my head is one space back. All right, we're going to have to go back this way. Pop. These are the benches. So we're waiting here for the train. Train's going to come up. It's going to stop. It's going to hit a powered rail, which is going to stop. It'll be unpowered, which means it'll have to stop. Now, let's see how we're going to do this. We need a back wall here. I think we're already. Yeah, let's put the rail up. Yeah, when a minecart hits an unpowered rail, it'll stop. And that's what we want. We want it to stop here automatically And then we'll be able to click a button to make it go again. And then we'll get a little power, a little speed. Yeah, I'm going to have to go around here, and I want to bury all those redstone torches. In fact, I think I took that one down, so we're going to have to power that one back up in a moment. But let's just do this. There should be enough power to get up here. Yeah, so this is what we're going to do with these guys. We're going to put it underneath. Down here. Where is it? And that should be perfect. They're going to be always on anyway, so we don't need to worry about that redstone torch ever again. It's doing its tang down there. All right. Now, I would like a way for people to get up here. People being me. So I'm going to put some stairs here, and I think maybe the stairs will go here. Again, I don't want this thing to be too big and ugly here. So let's see if that works. Now I'm going to need some walls. And I'm thinking maybe up about there. And let's see. One, two, whoopsie. No. There we go. Is that right? That's too high, I think. Yeah, you must come down. Because I want to have one pane of glass and then the roof. I'm going to lose my axe, am I? Yeah, that's too high. I would rather have it here. Like that. Yeah, that's okay. Again, I don't want this thing to be a big, ugly, sore thumb sticking out here by the farm. So, just enough for me to get over here and stop. And I guess that's good. Alright, now we need a way to activate this thing, and I have a button here for that purpose. So let's do this. Put another button there. Another block there, although I wonder. See, here's one of the tricky parts about this. Stop farting over there! Is whether or not we can hit that button in such a low block. So here's what's going to happen. That's going to hit that and automatically stop. We're going to be in it, obviously. And then when we're ready to pop out, we get here, we're like, okay, now I can either hop out and farm, or I can press the button and go. And that has to be on a, that powered rail has to be on a decline for that to start rolling automatically. Of course, now with Minecraft, I think 1.4, if you give this, see, if you're in the cart, you can push forward and it will roll a little bit. You can do that too, but I just like the idea of being able to press a button and not having to do that. So I like that, how that's automatic. The button right there is fine, which means I can potentially eliminate that block. And how about, it's already getting dark. I just started. Now, how are we going to do this? Yeah, this is going to be really low, but it doesn't have to be that high, honestly. Again, it's just a train stop, not a train station. We'll come out one more, just to keep the rain off our passengers' heads. Dun, dun, dun. That ought to do. Okay. And you know what I could do here is, let's make some more stairs. I think I need more stairs. Let's make a set of stairs. Whoops. Oh no. I'm gonna need a new axe. Let's just whip up a new axe while we're here. I'm just going to make a stone axe because I think I may have another iron axe indoors. And I would like to potentially use that in a repair scenario. So let's see how this looks. I think that looks a little better, don't you? So that way it's all stairs. These are seats. And then you come over here. Although, wait a minute. This. Yeah, I don't want people to get on this track over here. You know, I don't want people to get confused. This is the danger zone. Don't go there. Danger, 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 Will Robinson. So we want people to stay away from the track in the front. And I'm wondering how that's going to look. I suppose that I could bring this back one more, couldn't I? And just utilize that block. Why don't we do that? Is that still centered? In fact, that is more centered. This is not centered. Yeah, let's do that then. I don't have an eye for these things, you see? Poof, gone. Let's get rid of that. And then we're going to knock this down. And somebody got an eye on me here? My back? My backside? We're on a regular rail there. So regular rail goes there. And get rid of that. Actually, I'm going to put a stair there probably, right? So let's put the powered there. Put the button back here. And come on back, Dwight. Like so. Put another block here. Again, we keep people off the track there. Yes. Yes, that's a little more compact than before. So there you go. All right, I like that. And we need some lighting and some glass. Now that's going to be a problem. Creepers on the track. But I think I had mentioned, you know what, I have a stake. I had mentioned in the last episode where in 1.5, that's going to change. The track is going to be safe from things from crawling around. Apparently, monsters and animals will be afraid of the track. In other words, they will not cross it and walk around on it. That's the idea anyway. But I don't know if that's actually going to work out. Eh, it's just a zombie. Bonk. Just wondering how long they'll burn with a fire aspect one. Not very long, huh? All right, let's get rid of that block up top here. Of course I can't get that. Which means I'm going to have to put some dirt down and climb up. Old school style. Well, you know what I could do is make a little bit of an angle here. Oh, wait. I don't have enough. Okay, I guess I'll have to hold off on that. I'm going to have to make some more half slabs. I'll tweak the look here in a moment, but yeah, we could put like a stair here instead, maybe? No, I think that'll be fine. Let's put up a torch here and there for now. And I think we're good to go. Let's get, I just want to get some glass. I hear a cat. Oh, there they are. My pets are out in the field. I kind of sort of try to keep them out of the way from that project because they do make an awful racket. As if the chickens don't, right? Let's go see if we have a little bit of glass, and we'll give this rail a try. And what don't we need? All right, I need, I think, 3 panes. Oh, by the way, yeah, some funny stuff in the comments here. I wrote down a whole bunch. I took a bunch of snapshots as well. Let me just get rid of some of this stuff. Yeah, there's an interesting thing happening here. Maybe you'll notice it, maybe you won't, but some people have. Someone said my glowstone dust was... the comment was actually your glowstone sideways. And I saw that a lot of times. I saw that comment over and over. Whoops. On a few occasions, not on the last episode, but the one before that. And when I saw that, I was like, wait a minute, how... What the... Oh, chicken and a biscuit. I thought, well, how can my, thank you. How can my glowstone, how can a glowstone block be sideways? It couldn't hey! Villager! Zombie villager! Problem is, I don't have golden apple. Oh, no. Wait, dude. Don't go away. Man, we can get a third dude. Population 3 in Vinville, if we can get this guy. But anyway, so I was thinking, well, how can a block be sideways? Or maybe they said upside down or something like that. I'm like, all right, glowstone block can't be. And I knew immediately what they were talking about. I know that, I put the picture frames, these object frames down below, and I thought I had stuck a glowstone block in there. What am I doing here? Oh, we need to make potions. Oh, dear. Do I have a weakness potion? I do. I don't have an apple. Need a golden apple. All right. Shucks. All right. I need an apple. This is why I need an apple orchard. No. Let's go harvest some trees and maybe get an apple orchard. Maybe get one apple. Actually, let's check the food down here. Maybe there's an apple down here. Darn. No. Shoot. All right. Well, I'm going to put the buttons in here for now. I don't need those. Okay. Unfortunately, this guy's probably already despawned. And we're going to have to go find some oak trees and get an apple. So getting back to the whole glowstone thing. Oh, and the sun's coming out, so forget it. He's going to roast. So I thought about that. And I was like, well, wait a minute. How could that be? I can't, you can't have a sideways block. But it turns out that it was glowstone dust. And that was indeed, it was a piece of glowstone dust somewhere. And you'll just have to figure that out. Where? And see if you can notice. The glowstone dust is fixed now. But it might be something else. It's kind of like a little Easter egg. It's cool. It's a little Easter egg hunt. Let me just fix all this up. I'm going to go all the way around the track and hide the redstone. And we're going to have to make a... we're going to make another stop over here, I think. All right. All right, let me just run around the track and do this off camera. It's just it's kind of a laborious task and not going to be very interesting. So let me do that, and then we're going to go accomplish a few more tasks that I have written down. So hang tight, I'll be right back. All aboard! First stop, farms. Second stop, Vinville. Welcome aboard the Macho Pikachu Vinville line. All right, here we are at the farm. Wait, I didn't want to stop here. Actually, I did. I wanted to do a complete test run, but we have to stop here for a couple of things first. In fact, I'm going to grab one of you guys. Thank you. And just don't need you in my hand. Oh, wait, no, use the new. Yeah, see, new stairs right here. In fact, I took the stair away here because I don't want people getting their feet caught on the tracks. Just for safety purposes. That's right, I had an inspection recently and I was fined for that. You'll note that I removed the powered rail here because it was hurtling me forward just a little bit more than I wanted to go, and this cart would end up just a little too low on that decline. So when I clicked on it, I ended up outside the shelter. Yeah, it's a minor thing. But when I ended up out there, it was sort of aggravating, and I didn't want to be out there. So that's what I did, and that seemed to help. I also lowered these down by using half slabs, and I put some half slabs on the top to give it just a little bit of not being that flat look. All right, not being that flat look. There's some good English. All right, so I have you, because we're going to go make an iron golem. I've got plenty of iron at Vinville. Well, let's just make the whole rounds here first. There we go. Whee! Don't forget to remind me you need to get an apple over there. So yeah, the name of this railroad, and whoa, Whoa. Whoa. Oh, wow.
Yum.
Oh, you shot me. I was going to say yum, but he didn't. All right, let's keep going. Oh, see, this one you got to get a little shove, which I'm not too happy about. Yeah, I'm going to have to change that. I don't have to knock it off. Just back off. Back up, back up, back up, back up. Come on! I think the rain is screwing me up. No! Dude, wrong way. Yeah, we're going to have some security issues, at least for a little while. That's going to have to be dealt with. I don't think it's going to be a problem when 1.5 comes out when they don't walk on the track any longer. Let's keep trucking. There we go. So yes, it's the MP and V line. And we want to get off right here. Thank you. And we'll make a stop here, just like that stop over there, eventually. So here we are at Vinville. We have to make a change here as well. But so yeah, a suggestion that I had in the comments, actually several suggestions that I've had in comments. One was to change this to show the population, which we will do. And just remember that established date, 1-7-2-13. That was actually January 7th, not July the 1st. Some people were confused by that because the date format is different in different parts of the world. So anyway, there you go. So it's Vinville. I'll spell the whole date out this time. Vinville established January 7-2-1-2-0-1-3. Ah! 20. Shucks. All right. Established Jan. Bear with me here, people. Jan 7-2-1-2-0-1-3. Stop saying that. And then population. Population 2. That was actually an old suggestion from a while ago. And I'll see if I can locate that screenshot that I took. As you know, I do take screenshots and I try to stuff them in. Hey, come back. If you're going to drop your ball, I'll take it. Maybe not. Yeah, so I take screens and I put them in the videos if I remember. So that was one. Another one was make an Iron Giant in the village, which I had talked about already. But thanks for that suggestion. And yeah, there's the thing about making these in the village, though. Making them yourself is that they're not quite as effective as guardians. How many do I need? I need 4, right? Oh, this is expensive, man. Because they have a different code. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yeah, 4. And the code of the ones that you generate, the ones that you craft personally, are not as smart as the ones that spawn organically on their own to protect the villagers. Because they... the way I understand it is if you make one, and we're going to make one right now, they kind of wander around and they only attack bad guys within like 5 block distance. And they can't detect where an enemy is somewhere around or even attacking a villager. Unlike the ones that are made that just spawn on their own automatically in the world due to there being a whole bunch of villagers that need protecting. So that's one thing. So it's not going to be as effective, but it should help somewhat. So here we go. And we'll have to come up with a name for this guy. Bonk. Hello. All right. Go protect. Do something. Now, the ones that spawn organically also know when a zombie siege happens, and they will literally hunt down every single zombie in that siege, which is a special event. And that's something that you only get when the ones that spawn naturally. Okay, let's go get some apples. I don't want to ever get caught without an apple, a golden apple again. It's like getting caught with your pants down is how they say that. That's the term. And we're going to go over to where I'm going to eventually build an orchard, just like the one I did in my tutorial world, which is going to be right over here. So we're going to go chop down some trees in the rain, which is probably not, I mean, in the dark, which is not the smartest thing to do, but. But it is what it is, and we got work to do, so let's do it. There we go. Oak trees give the apples. So yeah, we'll put that orchard right here. In fact, that was designated as a spot for an orchard, apple orchard, even before I did my orchard tutorial. That's when I was considering changing to this world for that. I have protection, projectile protection 4. You're just wasting your time and mine. Be gone with ye. Silly. Hopefully we get at least one apple out of this. Alright, we'll let those decay a little bit. You know, I'm gonna need that wood anyway. So let's get another one. And yes, I know I'm hungry, and I will eat here momentarily. Let's get these things going. We're gonna need wood because one of the next projects is going to be building a some kind of a connecting room or chamber or tunnel between Vinny and Dante so that they can make friends. They can be friends. They can say hi and have share in each other's company because right now they're all alone and all locked up, and I would really like to get them together, but I'm not quite ready to release them from their secure rooms. I mean, into the, you know, freedom into the village. I'm not ready for that yet. Oh, come on. I need eppers. I need eppers. Let's go cut down another tree here. Cut down a couple trees, actually. So then once we get them together, maybe they will whip up some more villagers. Can't think of a better description. Oh, I love that this thing has looting too. Isn't that awesome? Get extra stuff. Just one apple's all I need. Just one apple. Come on, we can do it. All right, so what else is there to talk about while we're waiting for apples? Let me check my log here. Hang on. Well, I guess that's about it. I've covered most of the suggestions and things that I had in the comments. Let's go chop down another tree. I am very surprised I haven't gotten at least one apple so far. But this video is about 24, 25-ish minutes. There we go. Thank you. Come on down here, you. That's all I need is one. So I think it's long enough. I'm out of time. And don't worry, I still remember that we're supposed to talk about some other things. Kind of YouTube-ish related sort of stuff, which we'll get to. And I think we're going to call it quits for now. So I think what I'll do is for the next episode is I'll have all this cleared out, and then we'll make our apple orchard here so we get a supply of apples. It'll look very nice. And then we'll start thinking about securing this rail and finishing up that this station right here. Oh, and you need a T-junction there and then a ranch for my cows because they do keep escaping, and I'll make a nice fence around them to keep them in. All right, I think that's it for now, folks. I'm going to head out. I've got to get ready for a big storm coming up. Tomorrow, supposed to snow all day tomorrow, and then through Saturday, we might get up to 2 feet of snow. So I'm going to go buy a snowblower because I am not going to shovel. Not this time. And my oldest son's shoulder is, it's been damaged. He's tore a ligament there in wrestling practice. So he's going to be useless in shoveling. So I'm going to have to do it all. All right. I'm out of here. We'll see you all soon. Hope you have a nice weekend. Have a good one. Bye-bye. Place isn't overrun. What? What's the matter? Come back here. I don't see them yet.